Hello my dear viewers, welcome back to this video again. I'm very happy to see all of you here in my channel. Hope you got some information about the ESL companies. So now, as you see on the title below, we are going to develop a new skills and information about the pivoting strategies and the ESL pivot. So where is the pivot point or strategy, and how can this strategy help us to find out our accurate business or our direction to the work, and how can we improve ourselves from this strategy? Let's see. So where is a pivot strategy? A pivot means fundamentally changing the direction of a business when you realize the current products or services aren't meeting the need of the market. And the main goal of a pivot is to help a company improve their revenue or survive in the market. But the way you pivot your business can make all the difference. This thing can also be applicable in the ESL companies as well. Whether it is an online ESL company or an offline ESL company, according to your position, whether you are a teacher in any language, English, Arabic or French or any other language among the world, so you can use it and you can improve yourself with this strategy. And from here we can know the definition of a pivot in business. So the pivot in business is primarily a shift in the business strategy which is applied for testing out a new approach related to the startup business model after receiving the feedback. It is one of the core concepts of the Lean Startup method, a reason why it is also known as Pivot Lean Startup when we align Lean principles in our software development process and we always consider making a scope for applications pivot. And many times companies only have one question to address and need only one aspect to be changed. Okay, so now let's ask us a question. Now, when should you pivot? With a number of hotshot teacher kinds like Instagram, Facebook having popularized pivot success, the new age founders have grown to believe that pivot can be a great success formula for them too. But the truth is that pivoting must only be considered when you have exhausted all the other options. Here are the factors that can help you decide when to absolutely pivot in the business model. First of all, because there are so many, I'm gonna read for you the main contents of this content. Your company is always trying and failing to overall competition, and there is only one aspect of your business product that is getting the most attention. They said that you must pivot when your business objective and expectation has changed. So what are the different types of pivoting? So pivot in your existing market, reposition your product and do something entirely new. There are some best strategies that you must follow. The first one is that especially when you like pivot within your startup, so the first one is that you have to develop a prototype before you pivot. It's the main one, and it is the important one from all these best strategies that I'm going to share with you. To develop a prototype, like if you are thinking about pivoting startup, develop a prototype first and see if people would use it, find it valuable and give a feedback. Second one is to pick up the goals with aligning the business vision of your according to which type of business are you making. As an entrepreneur, it's important to know how your vision statement is changing, and gone is the time when there used to be one mission or a vision statement with the changing market. So the statements are also frequently changing, and most important to reevaluate what needs to be done and then draw a model to meet the new objectives. The third one is to ensure your pivot give out growth opportunities. The next step which have to be used is to ensure your pivot give out growth opportunities. It is useful like a next step when you have encountered red blocks. But if you pivot in a completely new direction without giving much attention to the plan, you would fail again and you don't hit another red block. So we would recommend two things. The first one is not expanding in the current market and perform an extensive market research. There are so many other strategies, like you consider alternative technology. The technology world is not what it used to be a decade, like even 2 years ago. For a startup to pivot, it is extremely important to be on the top of technology trends and keep the investors already said to keep the investors in loop, like at every pivot stage. And when you are taking the decision, make sure the investors are kept in the loop in case you think the company's mission and objective is going to change. So, and also analyze what your competitors are doing. I think this one is also quite important. Before pivoting, analyze what your direct competitors are doing and how you can do better. Okay, also understand your target market and problems, and after that you can do the successful pivot in business stories, or you can make your own pivoting system or strategies, whether it is about the ESL companies or in another kind of business. So when thinking about the present opportunities in education, there is a need for educators to pivot, that is to turn from a central point. And that central point can be represented as the way we have always done the things. So I think it's all about my video. Thank you so much for listening until the end, and I hope you got some information about pivoting strategies. So if you are interested more about these topics, you can let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to share this video with your friends and with your family members, and don't forget to please like my video and subscribe to my channel for further information. See you later. Bye.